and agricultural community, which has been hit hard by the dispute. Both countries have also called off scheduled tariff increases. President Trump said the two nations will immediately start negotiating a more comprehensive phase two deal. So how much progress has actually been made? Well, some are more skeptical than others. George Washington University professor Dr. Susan Ariel Aaronson is a critic of the Trump administration's approach. I talked to her about the dispute to get her reaction to this new phase one deal.
So what did Trump do? He put high tariffs on all sorts of manufactured goods coming from China. China, in turn, as it is allowed to do under international rules, retaliated with high tariffs of its own. The whole thing, in my mind, is truly silly because it is an ineffective way to deal with it. And moreover, when the Chinese government had a press conference, it was quite clear that what they thought they had agreed to is extremely different from what U.S. Trade Representative Lighthizer said they had agreed to. So, well, I think there will be a deal because both nations want to tamp down economic concerns at this moment, right? Trump needs to look like he's scored victories in trade. But I would say that this agreement, which covers some sectors of trade, doesn't even get back to where we were before Trump started this whole thing. So it's ineffective and frankly unhelpful.
Some of President Trump's supporters would say that they are glad that he's going after China for its theft of intellectual property and other wrongdoing. What would you say to them?
The best way to do it is to, in ways that bolster the rule of law and bolster business certainty. I agree with you that some Democrats, as well as supporters of President Trump, have lauded him for being, shall we say, ballsy. But it's great to be ballsy. That doesn't mean that it is effective. And the way to be effective is to establish commitments and a dispute settlement mechanism and leverage, right? If you read The Art of the Deal, which I have not read, but I know something about negotiating, you have to give to get. And particularly in trade, you have to give to get because trade, by definition, is about mutual benefit. So if you disagree on what you're giving and getting, right, if the rule of law is not there, that's a problem. And if you don't have a respected system of dispute settlement, that's a problem. And this agreement doesn't seem to establish those things.
Some lawmakers want hearings after the Washington Post released the Afghanistan papers. When we return, we'll hear what